CI is a vinyl record pressing plant. We are celebrating our 50th anniversary right now. We go back decades pressing Blue Note records. Tone Poet calls for the ultimate care from start to finish. This is the finest iteration of Blue Note music on vinyl that's ever been done. There's a lot of importance to this Blue Note Blue Train project. It's very important for Blue Note. It's very important for RTI. All hands on deck. Now that we've talked about it, it's time to see it. Let's go see this process from start to finish.
Hi, my name is Devin, and I work in the plating department here at RTI. So this is basically the first step of the process in making a vinyl record. We receive lacquer discs that I help prep for processing. So normally when we get a shipment in, we figure out who the customer is, who it belongs to, and what processing step that we will be applying. So in this case, I am processing a job that is to be three steps. First, we remove the lacquer discs from the package and we inspect it for any obvious flaws that it may have sustained in transit or any obvious signs of, just like any scratches or leaches or anything like that. And it's a very, very careful process. There's often spacers in between each lacquer disc and sometimes they like to stick to them. Each day we go through about 8 boxes of these on average. After these are inspected and scribed with our house number, they then prep them for silvering.
Hi, I am Adam Webb, and I am a supervisor in the plating department for RTI. I'm gonna be talking about the beginning of our process here in plating. More or less get the lacquer to conduct electricity so that we have the ability to plate it and then duplicate it over and over so that we can continue to make records. So the first thing we're going to do after we receive the lacquer from the mastering engineers is we're going to sand the center for the label and then sand the outer edge to help us prevent from separating while the parts are in the tank. The next thing that we do is score the outer edge, exposing the aluminum substrate so that when we do deposit silver over the face of the lacquer, it makes a complete circuit so that electricity can flow from the center completely to the outer diameter, allowing the nickel to adhere to the face of the lacquer. Once that is done, we will make a mother and a master in the nickel tank. The solution that we plate in is a nickel sulfamate solution, and it allows the nickel to be reduced to a extremely tiny particle, just a little bigger than an atom. That solution allows the nickel to travel from its raw state onto the lacquer, and it will piece by piece reconstruct the structure of each individual groove and each modulation and so on and so forth until it becomes robust enough for us to actually pull it off in one solid piece. And this is the electroplating department. What we have here is our stamper finishing section of the plating department. And what we do here is we prep the stamper to be mated with our pressing dies on our SMT presses. And the first thing that needs to happen is the backs of our stampers need to be prepared as they come out with this matte finish. We have a machine that will automatically sand. It will sand the back of the stamper, creating a smooth finish, allowing the stamper to mate with the die on the press, allowing the transfer of heat and cooling through the stamper that will allow the vinyl to flow, creating your vinyl record. So after this finishes, we end up with a stamper that is nice and smooth on the back. And the next thing we need to do is make sure that the music gets centered for your vinyl record. And what we do here is we will look at how much movement we have with the lockout groove. This line represents your lockout groove, and we have an extreme amount of movement here. So using this machine, we will manually make adjustments to make that lockout groove stop moving. Why this is important is because the hole that is in your record and the placement of that depends on this lockout groove. So we punch a hole in the center of the stamper, and that will allow us to evenly form the inner and outer diameter of the stamper. So next we take our stamper to our forming machine, and we'll take the stamper and we will install it. Make sure that it is securely installed. And then we will let the machine do the work. So now we have trimmed the edge, formed the edge, and formed the center. And this will allow us to mount and secure the stamper into a press so that we can make you your records. This is the final step in the plating department before our stampers go to pressing.
We're about to go into the press room where the magic happens. We have 9 presses that pump out about 100 records an hour. Come take a look. Throughout production, a QC inspector will pull a record off the press, bring it into a quiet listening room to check certain specs to make sure that the record's being pressed on center and it's as quiet as the test pressing that was approved by the customer. I'm going to look through the microscope at the lockout groove to make sure that it's centered. This one looks good. We're here in the finishing department at RTI, and we let all of our records that we press cool for about 12 plus hours, give them sufficient time to cure and settle flat. And then they are hand sleeved and visually inspected out here. So each sleever has a list of about 10 or more things that they're looking for with each record, different defects that can be spotted visually. If anything is in question, they'll take it into QC to have it approved or rejected. So they look at both sides under a strong light and carefully sleeve the record without touching the playing surface. So every day, each sleever sleeves approximately 30 spindles, and each spindle has about 100 to 120 records on it. After the records are inspected and sleeved, they go to a jacketer who inserts the sleeved records into a gatefold jacket, inspecting the jacket to make sure that there's been no defects or damage in shipping. All of our Tone Poet Blue Note releases get put in a poly bag, which is a loose-fitting packaging option that gives a little more room for the record to breathe and won't shrink over time. The Blue Note Complete Masters Stereo reissue is going to get a Tone Poet hype sticker at the next stop. 10 gatefold jackets go into an inner pack over here. This is the final step in the process. We're here in the shipping department. These copies of Blue Train are getting ready to get wrapped on a pallet and sent to Germany. Our shipping department sends records all over the world.
Okay, man, this is the final step. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. It's beautiful, man. They just did a beautiful job on this. Hermetic seal. All right, you ready?